click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, myself Professor Uday Hukre, and now I am welcoming you on your own YouTube channel Ikeda. If you are watching my video for first time, I request you to subscribe to our channel Ikeda and also press bell icon for your latest notifications. Friends, today we are going to learn for CA Inter course accountancy subject, topic name company final account, question number 6, which is on your screen. Let's read the question, students. From the following information furnished by Pioneer Limited, prepare the balance sheet as at 31st March 2001. As required by Schedule 3 of Companies Act, give notes at the foot of the balance sheet as may be found necessary. So what we need to prepare, students? We need to prepare only a balance sheet of this company. Let's go through the trial balance and let's decide which amount can be placed at what place in your balance sheet. Let's read each and every item slowly. Equity capital will appear as your share capital. Call scenarios will be subtracted from the equity share capital. Land, building, plant and machinery, furniture will be your tangible fixed asset. General reserve will be placed in your reserve surplus. Loan from State Financial Corporation will be placed as a secured loan. Inventory will be your inventory. Provision for tax will come as your short-term provision. Trade receivable will appear as a trade receivable. Advances are given on the debit side. So now here we gave the advances. It is subjective. You can assume it as a short-term or you can assume it as a long-term. So we are assuming here as a short-term loans advances. Dividend payable is your other current liability. Profit and loss account will appear in your reserves and surplus. Next amount is cash balance is your cash and cash equivalent. Cash at bank is your cash and cash equivalent. Unsecured loan, we are assuming it as a short-term borrowing, but alternatively we can even assume it as a long-term borrowing. It is subjective, so we are assuming it as a short-term borrowing. Trade payable for goods and expenses is your trade payable. The following additional information is also provided. 2000 equity shares were issued for consideration other than cash. So it will be mentioned as a note in your share capital. Trade receivable of 52,000 are due for more than 6 months. So it is a breakup for your trade receivable. Cost of the asset will be mentioned as a cost. Whatever balance is given in your trial balance or your WDV, the difference between cost and WDV will be your provision for depreciation. The balance of ₹1,50,000 in loan account with State Finance Corporation is inclusive of 7,500 for interest accrued but not due. That means loan include interest amount which should have been shown as the other current liability. So what I will do, corrective action, minus from the loan, and I will show it as the other current liability in my balance sheet. The loan is secured by hypothecation of plant and machinery. This will be a note to be mentioned. Balance at bank include 2000 with a perfect bank, which is not a scheduled bank. So it is a breakup of bank simply. Company has contract for erection of machinery at ₹1,50,000, which is still incomplete. So it is contingent liability. So this will be shown as a contingent liability. Nothing more than that. We will draw the format of balance sheet now. Friends, you can notice I have drawn the balance sheet format. In this format, where there are only one items in particular note, I have not prepared note for it, I have directly written. That is, for example, in your current liabilities, short-term borrowing, we have only unsecured loan, so I have written directly. Same will happen with any other item. If there is only single amount, I will directly write. But if there are multiple items or if there are adjustments, I will prepare a note only for that. That is acceptable. So friends, after preparing a format of balance sheet, I need to prepare notes for the respective balance sheet. Friends, now we will read additional information. We will firstly complete our additional information and then we will go about the rest of the amounts in your trial balance. The following additional information is also provided. 2000 equity shares were issued for a consideration other than cash. It is merely a note to be disclosed in your share capital. Let's come to the share capital. Friends, I need to write authorized capital. In this entire example, they have not mentioned what is authorized capital. So if there is no authorized capital, we need to mention question mark in your amount. After authorized capital, I need to write issued, subscribed and paid up capital. Friends, you can notice equity share capital here. Amount is 10 lakhs, face value is 100. So I can say that your number of shares are 10,000 shares of rupees 100 each. From that I need to minus calls in arrears. So our net capital is 9,99,000. Out of these shares, some shares are issued for consideration other than cash, so we need to mention. Note we have written. Of the above, 2000 equity shares were issued for a consideration other than cash. So I need to take a total now. That total is 999,000 worth obviously. This we will place in the balance sheet at the end. Next information, trade receivable of 52,000 are due for more than 6 months. It is merely a breakup of your trade receivable, so we need to write down that. So friends, trade receivable we need to write breakup. The amount of trade receivable given is 2 lakhs. It will be broken into two parts, outstanding for more than 6 months and other debtors. My total amount of debtors is 2 lakhs. Out of that, 52,000 are due for more than 6 months. So remaining debtors are 148,000. Other debtors. Let's go with the next information, students. Next information is given cost of asset, building, plant and machinery, furniture. So we need to write the cost. In trial balance, we have a WDV. The difference between trial balance amount and this cost, the difference between trial balance amount and the cost which is given, is depreciation provision that I will mention in my fixed asset note. I will be copying costs from my this information. ₹4 lakhs. Now let us see in trial balance what is the amount of building. Building amount is 3,50,000. If my net amount is 350 and if my original cost is 4 lakhs, my PFD will be 50,000. In the same manner, I will record other assets. So students, I have written all three assets. Original cost I have copied from the information and WDV I have copied from my trial balance. The difference is my depreciation provision which I have mentioned as a PFD. Next information given, the balance of rupees 1,50,000 loan account with State Finance Corporation is inclusive of 7,500 interest accrued but not due. The loan is secured by hypothecation of plant and machinery. So I need to write a breakup of the loan. Out of the loan amount, whatever interest I have included there by mistake, I will minus from that interest. From that loan amount, I will minus the interest. And that interest I will place separately as other current liability. इंटरेस्ट आउटस्टैंडिंग था वो हम लोगों ने अदर करंट लायबिलिटी में लिख दिया एंड इट विल बी रिड्यूस फ्रॉम योर सिक्योर लोन ऑफ दैट स्टेट फाइनेंस कॉर्पोरेशन. आउटस्टैंडिंग इंटरेस्ट ऑन SFC लोन, स्टेट फाइनेंस कॉर्पोरेशन लोन आई हैव रिटन हियर एंड दिस अमाउंट आई विल माइनस फ्रॉम द लोन अमाउंट विच इज 1,50,000. द नोट नंबर फॉर लॉन्ग टर्म बोरोइंग आई हैव नॉट गिवन, सो आई विल राइट द लास्ट नोट नंबर हियर. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम यूजिंग नोट नंबर 8 हियर. We have missed out the note number here. So I have written only note number 8 here. Okay. So alternatively, I could have written 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. So I have written here note number 8 for your long term borrowing. Doesn't matter. Note is there. In trial balance, loan amount is given 1,50,000. Less outstanding interest wrongly included. Net amount of loan is 142,500. In information number 4, they are also saying that this loan is secured by hypothecation of plant and machinery. So I am writing that also as my note. Secure by hypothecation of plant and machinery. Next information, balance at bank include 2000 with a perfect bank which is not a scheduled bank, so that we will write. In cash and cash equivalent, I need to write firstly cash on hand and then I will write bank balance. They mentioned cash balance, so I am writing cash balance. In bank balance, we have a breakup with scheduled bank and with non-scheduled bank. Our bank balance total is 2,47,000, out of which 2,000 is with a non-scheduled bank. Therefore, my balance with scheduled bank will be 2,45,000. This is what the interpretation we have taken. Next information, students. Next is contingent liability, which is given. Company has a contract for erection of machinery rupees 1,50,000, which is still incomplete. It is a contingent liability for which we will write a note here. In notes to account part only, we will write this contingent liability. So I have written contingent liability in notes part only. The company had a contract for erection of machinery at rupees 1,50,000, which is still incomplete. So in this way I have noted my contingent liability. all informations are done. So I need to take up remaining items from my trial balance. Equity capital call scenario is taken. Land is there, which I need to mention in my fixed assets. So land done. Building, plant and machinery, furniture already recorded. General reserve will come under the heading reserves and surplus. After general reserve, loan from State Finance Corporation that we have included. Inventory will be recorded in inventory. There are two inventories, finished goods and raw material. So inventory is written. Next amount, provision for tax that we have mentioned in the bracket. This you can notice, students, provision for tax mentioned in the bracket. Next is trade receivable. We have written it with a breakup. Advances we have written short-term loans and advances. Already we have noted advances, short-term loans and advances. Dividend payable is your other current liability. Profit and loss account will be mentioned under the reserves and surplus, 86,700. So we have written profit and loss account, reserve surplus mein likha hai, 86,700. Cash balance we have taken. Cash at bank we have taken. Loans unsecured, 1,21,000, that we have taken directly in the balance sheet. Trade payable also we have taken as a trade payable. So we have completed trial balance completely. Now we have to write totals of all those notes. Reserve surplus total is 296,700. Other current liability amount is 67,500. Total of fixed asset I need to take. It is 11,25,000. Inventory total is already done, that is only one amount, 2,50,000. Trade receivable 2 lakhs. Cash and cash equivalent is 2,77,000. And long term borrowing amount is 142,500. Friends, now I need to write all these totals in my format of balance sheet step by step. So students, I have recorded all amounts what we have recorded in our note, and when I have written this in my note, my balance sheet tallies at 1,894,700. Every amount of the note is put in the balance sheet, right? 1,894,700 is my total of the liability side, equity and liability side, and also on asset side I found the same total, 1,894,700. So friends, in this way we have completed our simple question. There is no confusion at all in this question. But still, if you have any doubts about this question, please put in the comment box. We'll try to reply your queries at earliest. Thank you for watching this video, students. God bless you.